Hello everybody, this is Nicole with HelpMamaRemote.com and I love helping moms by sharing videos on faith, family, home, and food. So if you haven't subscribed, please be sure to do so and click that little bell so you'll be notified when another video is uploaded. So we're back with week 5 on our Ephesians scripture memorization. So far we should have memorized Ephesians 1 verses 1 through 20. So today we'll be reciting verses 1 through 20, and next week we will only have to learn 3 verses, and the following week we will not go on to chapter 2 until we just continue to solidify our memorization in chapter 1, as well as that week I will be sharing with you an Ephesians chapter 1 Bible study. So after we finish each chapter, I'll be sharing a Bible study with you. We'll dig into our word together and, you know, learn about Ephesians. So be looking forward to that. I'm getting questions for people that may be coming in when we're in week 3 or 4 or so on. And I would just suggest, if you really would like to do it, just start from the beginning and just go through the videos. Save the playlist and watch each video each week to help keep you accountable. And watch the current video so you will be also encouraged to continue on through. I know it's encouraging, you know, when you see other people continuing on through this process. It has been really, me doing the videos is also helping keep me accountable to persevering and going through with it. Because more than likely, if I was not doing the videos, I would probably like slack off. So it's been so helpful for me to doing these videos and sharing them with you. It's rewarding just getting to another, you know, finishing another set of verses. It's just so rewarding as you put them all together and the Lord reveals to you what it means. You can keep it in context of what the scripture means. So it's been so rewarding. It was some other things that I was thinking about this week and I did not write them down. So of course I forgot them. I should have wrote them down. So I'll be trying to make sure I write things down to share with you what I'm learning from doing this as well. So this week we'll be reciting verses 1 through 20. And my cars are looking real shabby right now. You know, my baby gets a hold to them. They get tossed all over. I throw them in my purse and all that. So by the time we get done, they'll look like somebody's really well-loved Bible. So, okay, y'all, let's get started. This week, I've had to, like, cut in half. So, like, I forget what scripture verse it is. Maybe, like, between 16 to 20, I'll like recite those a lot this week and then add them to the next so that I can solidify the last 5 we've learned. So it's been a little challenging adding so many on to it, but one of the amazing things I am learning about this is that, like, the ones verses 1 through 10 or 12, I don't have to think about them. I can just recite them and they're like in my conscience. You understand what I'm saying? If that's making sense. I don't have to think. Whereas the newer verses I've learned, I have to think them through a little more. So each week as I continue to learn more, the previous verses that I've already learned just get more ingrained in my mind, my soul, and my spirit. So that is so rewarding to me. So let's get ready to recite these. I don't think I'm gonna flip through them this time. I'm gonna try not to flip through the scriptures. And like I say, if you're learning a different translation, just mute me and recite them as I recite it and turn it back up at the end of the video. So let's go. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, to the saints which are in Ephesus and the faithful in Christ Jesus. Grace be to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. According as he has chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. Having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself, according to his good pleasure and will. To the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he has made us accepted in the beloved, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace. Wherein he has abounded toward us with all wisdom and prudence, having made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he has purposed in himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of time he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestinated according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will, that we should be to the praise of his glory, who first trusted in Christ, in whom ye also trusted, after ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also after that ye believed. You were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise, which is the earnest of our inheritance, until the redemption of the purchased possession, unto the praise of his glory. Wherefore I also, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus, and love unto all the saints, cease not to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling, what is the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power to usward who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ, when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in heavenly places. Okay, so that was 1 through 20. And so now we have 3 more to learn. And so 21, far above all principalities and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in that which is to come. 22, and hath put all things under his feet, and gave him to be the head over all things to the church. 23, which is his body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all. So that will be chapter 1. We'll be completing next week, and then, like I say, the following week we would just continue to memorize chapter 1. To solidify it and to just allow it to be ingrained in our minds, in our spirit, and just allow the Lord to minister to you and reveal to you his word as we prepare for our Bible study that following week. So I'd like to thank you guys for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please be sure to do so, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.